I had a phone call one day from somebody in the north of England. He said, "What are the rules and regulations in regard to preserving humans?" He said, "I'm being honest, my grandmother wanted to be skinned and stuffed and sat in her chair." Okay, I'll look into it. Put the phone down. And of course, I'm thinking it's too personal, too close to your own species. I'm not going to do it. I suppose some people might sort of like think taxidermist is sort of like weird, macabre, because a lot of people don't understand what taxidermy is about, and they have a basic idea that we do something with animals, maybe, and we preserve them, but we are weird. I must say, we're weird to some extent. I became a perfectionist early in life. If something wasn't right, I wasn't happy. I had to get it exactly right. And because I had such a vivid imagination of, say, the natural world, for example, and I used to like paint pictures, and if it wasn't how it should be, I'd just screw it up and try it again and again and again and again. If you're young and you have traumatic experiences, like you're taken away from your mother, or you suffer illness in your very young life, usually you open your mind up. I'm always thinking all the time. Even if I'm sat in a tree watching a badger set at dusk, hoping to see little striped faces coming out of holes and sniffing the air for danger, I'm always thinking. There's a certain time in the evening when everything just stops dead. If it's been rainy in the day or windy, just at dusk, everything is always dead. When I used to watch wildlife in the hills around where I lived, you know, I got more than I bargained for. I didn't just see badgers and deer. I saw spacecraft in the skies. And I realised that in all the ancient myths around the world and holy writings, they all stemmed back to the same thing, and that was that there were beings that came from another world that helped the evolution of mankind. Before long, we will move from this earth in machines. We won't be earthlings anymore. We'll be spacelings. We'll be beings on another planet. And if other beings on earth survive, well, then surely they will only see us as gods, especially if we come back and tell them how to live and how to love each other, not destroy themselves. We will be classed as gods. The authorities hide so much. It's incredible. They've even got secret vaults with thousands of witness reports, which they hide. We know, for example, I'm involved in big cat research. The government agencies won't acknowledge the fact that big cats live in the UK. And that's just something very, very small. It's got nothing to do with UFOs or anything like that. I actually know there are conspiracies. There's been conspiracies in regards to my own childhood. And when I've witnessed that, and I know how the local government would lie for their back teeth to hide something of controversy, then I know that it's going to happen with even bigger things.